This is the Woodland Scenics Clump Foliage, and let's take a close look. That's perfect for making bushes or trees. If you want a whole forest for a mountain scene, you can use it that way too. Now this bag costs between $7 and $8 at a hobby store. And it's a good sized bag, you get a lot of product, but you can make your own. I'm going to show you how to do it in this cool video. That right here, $5.98. I went to a store called Joanne Fabrics, and they had a really good selection of foam. I guess this would be used for making pillows or mattresses or whatever, but for me, I picked up a small package, 1 inch thick, and I cut it into slices, and then I cut it into small cubes, and then it goes in the blender. Yes, I said use a blender. Now, you don't need anything too fancy. This is my blender. This is the advantage of living by yourself. I don't have to ask permission anymore. So here's my blender. I put all my foam blocks in there, and I use regular tap water. And the goal is just to make sure you got them all wet so that they sink to the bottom. If they're not wet, they're going to bounce around and not get chopped up. So I pour this in. Don't go crazy. This is trial and error. I didn't invent this idea. I saw it on the internet. I thought I'd give it a try. Put that lid on tight. And I just tried different speeds. There is no set time limit. It didn't take me that long, only a few minutes. Different speeds may get it done faster. But don't be afraid to stop it. Take the lid off and check to make sure that all the big pieces are getting wet and going to the bottom. That way they get chopped up. Also, when you look inside, if you see anything that still looks square, you know that it's not ready yet. There shouldn't be any straight edges. This will chop it up just like the Woodland Scenics Clump Foliage. So we're getting there, we're getting there. Just a little bit more. When I feel that it's done, I use a big strainer and an empty container. And I'm going to pour it through the strainer into the container and get rid of most of the water. I had to do this a couple times, pour more water in just to get all those loose pieces out. Now what I did is I kind of squished a little bit, make sure that it's damp but not dripping wet, and I poured it all into this big container. I had a couple different acrylic paints. I ended up going with the bigger one. It was a little bit more expensive, but I think this color might turn out good. The thing I've noticed making a few batches of these is that it will come out a little lighter than what you originally thought. So when picking out your paint colors, go just like one shade darker. I'm trying to film this all with one hand. I didn't have a tripod in this tight little area. And I used Elmer's glue. Now there's two different schools of thought when using the Elmer's glue. If you use a little bit and it dries, you're going to have the nice clump foliage that you can apply to your layout later. But what I wanted to do is I added a lot of Elmer's glue and I mixed it up because it's going directly onto the layout. Now you can use a popsicle stick to blend this all together. Or have some more fun, get some rubber gloves, latex gloves, and get in there and mix it all good. This is my suggestion. And the reason why is you don't want any of that white to show through later. So you really got to get in there, mix the paint and the glue, squish it together. It'll return to its shape, don't worry. You might have to add a little bit more paint later. Now remember, it is going to look different because that white glue is going to make the color lighter. Don't panic. It almost looked a little bit fluorescent. I was starting to get a little worried, I'm not going to lie. But it does dry dark. Keep moving around. Make sure you got every little piece. Can't have anything white showing through. And then I went directly onto the layout with it. This is the river's edge. It does have a slight angle to it. But the fact that there's so much glue, it does stick to the walls. It sticks to it pretty well. But you do want to push it against it. It will come out with a nice shape. I'm going to tell you though, in a few hours, you'll notice that because it's still damp, there is paint, there is glue, gravity will take effect, and it'll start dripping down onto whatever the lowest part is. In this situation, it would be my future river. If you are doing this in an area with already finished scenery, cover that area up. It doesn't drip down right away, but over time you will see where it does. And I'm going to do this whole river's edge. And I know, you're looking at the background hill and you're like, okay, that's way darker than the foreground. It does dry darker. And I finished this section, and we're going to let it dry. Ah, I told you it would look good. See, as it starts to dry, it's going to dry from the top first, so the top area is darker. It's still squishy on the bottom. It's going to take a while. If you have humidity in the house, it's going to take a little longer than if you have a drier house. This is from weeks ago, and this is so solid. None of this is coming off. None of this is going to fall apart and land on your tracks and get stuck in your engine wheels. This is solid. Pretty slick, huh? Man, that's starting to look good. So it works. I like this technique. It was $5.98 for that sheet of foam, and I used only like a tenth of it, if that, and I got so much done. So I have more money-saving ideas on my YouTube channel, DJ's Train. Subscribe. You know all the fun stuff. Make sure you click that bell icon to be notified of future videos. And yes, I am now available in pumpkin spice. All right. Hey, bye-bye.